Hi everyone. Sorry about the wiggle. I was making sure everything was going to show up. I have you pulled down a little close because tonight we are going to talk about embellishments. So my last book flip was kind of a winter book and I had a lot of ideas and plans of things I wanted to try in it. And I got some interest back on people seeing my embellishment collection and whatnot. So I thought I would go ahead and get that done while it's nice and quiet. And that way it's out early enough in time for Christmas in case anyone is interested in picking up anything. This is just black acrylic paint. It's just for like the nail polishes and things. I'm going to show you how different they show up if you do them on black paper or a dark background. Okay, so the first thing I found for Christmas season, granted not everything I have is for Christmas, but this video will be themed around it a little bit just because a lot of it is stuff I have picked up for Christmas. So these are buttons. And I thought these were going to be perfect for snowmen. And I did try one, but I don't have my book right here, so I don't get to show you. But yes, there are lots of things, you know, scarves, coats, things like that that could use buttons. You could put them as eyes on things, stuffed animals, whatever. So, very cute. I'm excited to try them out. Some of them are kind of large and heavy for a coloring page, but we will kind of test it out and see how it goes. The next thing are these. There's probably more colors of them, but my pile got a little mixed up while I was looking for things. But these are gems from Dollar Tree, and you can just buy the whole sheet like this. You can either peel them off as a whole piece, or you can cut whatever shape and design you want out of it. These work really well for border pages for me. I just seen my book that had a border page in it, and I don't know where it went. I am just not together. But yeah, I really like to put them on borders sometimes. Jewels, things like that. So those are just fun Dollar Tree embellishments. The next ones are kind of the same. So you can cut them, adjust them to size and whatnot. And these are Dollar Tree as well. So a lot of my collection is going to be Dollar Tree or 97 cent Walmart aisle. A couple things I found on vacations, but that's all I have here for art stores is Walmart and Dollar Tree. So but I think if you get creative and they work great, and then I don't have to spend a whole bunch on embellishments when I can be buying more books. So I kind of like it. So these are for Christmas season. These are going to be the snowflakes, and then I'm going to try some of these iridescents out on a couple things. Maybe some eyes of some penguins. And of course, we've got some silver ones, maybe for stockings or for a Christmas tree. So I am really excited to try these as well. Someone asked me how I store things like this. So let me grab my... Okay, so I have a little cart with shelves, and this is a horrible mess. I'm sorry. But I just kind of throw my loose stuff in here until it finds a home. But I keep my sequins and things and glitter in these little cups, and you get like 4 or 6 for a dollar. I keep my glitter, so when I buy more than one packet of their glitter at the Dollar Tree, like, oh goodness, I don't even know, like these, then I can just combine them and not have to keep all these little separate packets. I don't know, it just seems easier to me. So yeah, I have sequins in here, glitter. Of course those can be used for tons of things. This is water for distressed ink, or you can make it watercolor spray or distressed ink spray if you know how to make your own. I've looked into it, but I have not tried it. Stamps. So Walmart has these. I'm not sure about these exact wood ones, but and they have ink pads too, and there are lots of different designs you can get. And they're cute for backgrounds or if you are... personalizing anything is what I was trying to think of. So I do have a few stamps. This one's going to be fun for Easter. You could use it like washi tape, make a border out of it and color it if you're into that kind of thing. So I do have a few of those. I haven't got a whole bunch. just because I haven't really used them, but I ran into a couple at a yard sale and thought they'd be fun to try. So I've tried them on a couple things. I've got a pumpkin one and a quilt one, so I'll set these stamps back. These are also Dollar Tree, and just so you know, someone was surprised to hear this, but they do come in colored ink. If you don't want that orange ink, dunk it in black. I mean, it's a Dollar Tree stamp. It's gonna be okay. But they are cute, as they are too. Of course, I have washi tape. So I have a massive collection of washi tape, so we won't go through the whole thing, but washi tape you can use on clothes, you can use in borders, you can make stockings out of it, you know, whatever, you can cut shapes out of it. The other kind of washi, I'm not sure everybody knows, is out, but you can get these neat flower shaped kind, and they just peel off, and they're just kind of washi tape stickers. I have only seen them in flowers, but once again, I only have a Walmart and a Dollar Tree. So these are usually, this I do think I found at Walmart, but washi tape I found usually is better other places. So this is a new Scotch washi tape, and their washi tape is thicker and the glitter seems to stick a little better. I don't think you'll be able to tell how thick this washi tape is compared to a normal one, but is that nice thick feel. So I do like this. This is going to be snow somewhere along the way. I have lots of plans just to try them out. So these ones aren't Christmas. I haven't picked up Christmas ones yet. They were out the last time I was there. But these are rub-on transfers, and I really like these. They come out nice and metally kind of looking. They keep that gloss. And you just cut out whatever little phrase or whatever you want. You don't have to use the whole thing at once. You put it down, you rub it, you peel it off. So, yes. Along with this, these are foil ones. They do have other types. But this is also a foil pen. So you get it nice and hot, you lay your foil down, and you write. If you wanted to trace a stencil or whatever with the pen, you could do that. So, foil pens are another option for embellishing. Okay, moving some stuff over. Trying to make sure I get to everything here. So, those are all there. These different types of glitter. This one is called a jumbo glitter. And I think they are really neat when you want that real bold glitter statement. I also have, let me pull them, I forgot. These beautiful glitters. Now, I was a little disappointed, I'm not gonna lie, and I have nobody to blame but me, but on the Amazon picture, I was expecting them to be a dot bigger because, as you can tell, you really only get a pinch. But for trying it out and for funsies sake, I think it's all right. I like them. So yes, this is called chunky glitter, if you are into that kind of thing. I put it on eyeballs, snows, dresses, everything like that. So there is chunky glitter, jumbo glitter, fine glitter. These are kind of the same. These are kind of like sequins. I thought this one might be fun to play with. Maybe not necessarily for snow, but maybe. Maybe I could mix it with some of the blue ones and give it a snow tint. That could be interesting. I am big on embellishing. I always try to add a little touch of something somewhere. It's just fun to me, way to make it my own. Because I know no matter how closely colored it is to somebody else's, they will never have the same embellishment I do. So this is shredded mylar. So what it is kind of like those treat bags you get for birthdays and stuff. They're cut up. And I am going to try this out also. So if you want videos on me trying any of these, good or bad, let me know down below and just say, you know, shredded snow, paint, snow, glitter, sequins, whatever. Give me an idea. Because like I said, I have a lot of things planned, but how many I will get to, I'm not sure. So if I have a priority list, it's always helpful. these are for Christmas, and I am very excited. These are just snowflakes. Tons of tiny snowflakes. Confetti. And they, they're not paper feely. They're more plasticky. Okay. Somebody wrote on this one, but, and I lost the other half to it. But here, oh yeah, I remember the shelf ate it. So there is another part running around, but these are just little white dots. They're not snowflakes, just white dots. And then there's red. And then of course there's a green one up here, but I thought this might be fun for a stocking or maybe a candy cane. Okay, here is my glitter collection. Not my complete collection, but I got this to try. I do want to try to mix these a little bit and get like a snowy shadow effect. So I need to find a real nice snow page. And then I need to hope I can show it as well as it looks in person. Okay, this is, these are tiny jewels, by the way, and I ruined this page, so I'm actually starting over, but I did the flower with the little jewels, and I really like it. So that hopefully will be on my completed pages if I get it fixed. So I need to put those jewels where I can find them. This is Art Deco nail art. So this is nail polish, and nail polish is super fun. So there's, you know, lots of things you can use it on, backgrounds, whatever. But this is white in time for snow season. So, you know, all you have to do is, let's pull this black paper out here. Is, you know, dot this. It comes in a real fine tip brush, precision pointed brush. And you can just, you can even draw wispies or whatever you desire. Nail polish is a little tricky though, so always test it out on something else before a big project. This is also fun, especially on black. And this, I think, came in actually one of my daughter's nail polish sets. I don't even think this is big kid nail polish. But always check these if you do them on white paper, because some of the nail polishes will turn yellow, and that's not good either. But I do have a wide variety of nail polishes. And like I said, I've used nail polish on fingernails, skies, wings, a cauldron. I sparklefied a cauldron. I sparklefied my Grim Reaper background. It's, nail polish is super fun to play with. And especially the darker the background, like I said, the more different nail polishes you can try. So like this pink one here, if you wanted bright pink polka dots on your black background, you could. And it might take a couple coats just because it is over black, but so that is fun. Another thing along with the nail polish, because mine are kept together, is Glitterific. Oh nope, not Glitterific, sorry, Extreme Glitter. It don't matter what color you get, it's whatever you want, but I have a lot of golds for the Christmas season. And when it dries, it will dry clear. That white won't stay there. So these are fun for, you know, the Christmas season, stockings, snow presents, tinsel. My green might be a little empty. Whoa, that was a lot, but that's okay. This one is pretty when it dries. I'll do a little streak right here because I have so much, so you can see what the Glitterific looks like on white paper. Dragon Glaze is the same. I'll do a metallic. This metallic blue, I probably almost need another one, is great for ice. Ice skating rinks, ice on house rooftops. You can put white under it if you want and give it a little more. I got glitter on my finger. But yes, this is folk art metallic ice blue. And it is one of my favorites for the Christmas season. I also am trying silver this year. I haven't tried it yet, but I think silver bells would be fun. No, that one doesn't look as metallic on black. Whoa! So there's those. And then there is another glitter that is called Glitterific acrylic paint, and it is the very, very, oh goodness, chunky glitter. So that one, I do like how it comes out, but it takes a lot of working it to get it. But that is Glitterific. And then of course I have a regular acrylic, I have regular acrylic paint and chalkboard paint. And chalkboard paints are fun for like stars, signs outside cafes, movie theater things, you know, teachers, chalkboards, things like that. So chalkboard paint comes in more than just the classic chalkboard color. So yeah, those are fun. They are fun to test out on the For You pages or Book Belongs To pages. Okay, here's two more different styles of glitter. So this one is very tiny disco, and this one is the bigger honeycomb shaped, and it's silvery and gold, has a kind of New Year's feel to it. This is eyeshadow, and it's a shimmer powder, and I just kind of wanted to show you if you're doing a sky or anything like that, and you can either leave it sit like that and spray on it, and it kind of makes a smoky look. It could be a smoke coming out of a chimney, snow flying up behind Santa Claus, you know, things like that. I know I'm kind of out there with my ideas, but I love embellishing. I really get excited. So here's another random washi tape. This one is all kinds of butterflies. If you don't want to use this as like a border or anything, you can, if you're real good, you could even cut around the butterfly with an X-Acto knife, the butterfly you want. But you could just cut them into squares, put one on each corner, make a checkerboard, whatever you want to do on your page. So I really like that idea too of the alternating pattern ones. An important one I feel you need is the straight black Scotch washi tape from Walmart. It's like $2, but there's lots of times when your page just needs a black border. There's so much going on that black is what it needs. I also found this kind of mixed glitter. And I'm probably going to have to turn this over because it's trying to focus on that. So it's blue and purple. I found this type of, this is called Fox Snow. So it's a little more poofy. It's going to be a little more 3D. But I thought it would be fun to use around maybe boots and bags and hats and things. I'm not sure how well that'll go. We will see. And then of course I got these cute little Christmas bow ties. And I will probably just cut this off because I obviously don't need to tie them. But I will just pull off that little bit and then glue them maybe to the corner of a page or on the arm of a chair or something like that. Give it a little Christmas touch. These are even bigger jumbo glitters. And I only have seen this, I don't remember which store it was in Michael's, but in the clearance section. So I have a lot of gold sparkles now, that's for sure. But those are fun. Okay, and then I have the very fine Christmassy gold color. I might mix a little of that in with my snow as well. I need lots of snow pages. All this going through and talking about it is just making me want to play with it. So there's the green ones that came off that other set. Just green sparkles. And then a blue washi tape. Another fun one to get is this, and it's just called Hobby Lobby Tape 2020, and it's iridescent, and I'm pretty sure Walmart has a version of it too, actually, but it's just like a mirror type. It looks a little blue in the light, but it's actually not. It's very iridescent. But this is really fun for mirrors or swords or, you know, metal or just anything you want to decorate there. Very, very fun. It is see-through, so if you put it over something and you need to cut out a shape, you can do that. If you draw a line on it with your fingernail, it'll get dark blue, so you can put designs in that way. So yes, there is that tape. I learned that over Halloween. Okay, next we have glitter. And I'm not gonna go through all my glitter, but I do have to unbury the rest of the pile. So this is a chrome and it's almost gone, but this is Sally Hansen Crystal Chrome. That was hard to say. And I will just show you a little right here why I like this color so much. I can't even find it anymore. Don't know that I've checked Amazon though, so there is still hope. But there is the crystal chrome, and I will put a dot over here just to see. I don't think it yellows, but I don't want to be wrong. Okay, so there's another nail polish for the nail polish collection. So here is the chrome down here, and then up here in the corner. Very shiny looking. I love it. Okay. Sequins, we talked about. These are also glitter from the clearance aisle at Michael's, I believe. And so I might not use them all for Christmas colors, but eventually I probably will get a page with them. So, let me move those off to the side. These are cute little bow ties, and I found them at a yard sale for 25 cents, it looks like. So I haven't tried them yet, but I do think this would look adorable on a penguin. Penguins might be too black, but yeah, I'm sure I can find something that needs a bow. Okay, these are bigger snowflake stickers, and they just have a little bit of glitter on them. I don't know if that's showing up. There we go. 21 minutes. I'm trying not to be too slow, but I have a lot of stuff. So, more glitter. And I really like these tops because they have the kind of, you know, the pour it all out at once and dump it on your page, or the sprinkle lightly style. These are super fun to put on Christmas trees to represent bulbs or lights or what have you. I will be doing a page with those, and because I was in the store and I was indecisive and I couldn't decide if those were going to be bright enough for a Christmas tree, I also got some other jewels. One second. So these obviously aren't for the Christmas tree, but they were fun black. I don't have a lot of black, but I got these I can take off to stamps. We talked about stamps, but there's this cute little set that Walmart sells now. It's your birthday, your symbols. I think these were like $4.88, and like I said, you can get any color ink. You can use your distressed ink, paint, whatever you want. Letters are very important in embellishing. If anyone is famous for a quote, if you want to put your name fancy on your book belongs to you page, then collecting these are rub-on, so you'll see some of these are stickers. Those are all stickers. I do have a couple rub-on, but these could be for Christmas or holidays or anything like that. Now these ones aren't Christmas. I don't have any Christmas ones yet. I'm assuming they will be out soon, but I wanted to show them anyway. So let me move some stuff over. Okay, these are stickers, but they are like the 3D stickers that pop out of the page a little bit. So these are super fun to add to the backgrounds, give your page a little pop. They are a quick and easy embellishment. If you stick them down and you don't like them and you pull them up, as long as you do it, you know, within a few minutes and you haven't added any glue or pressed down on it forever, it will come right off without ripping your page. I've done it a bunch. Still be careful, rip slowly, but these are fairly adjustable compared to other things. Okay, the others are more letters. These are just Dollar Tree stickers, seasonal stickers I found. That'll be fun to add to pages, or you could even put one like in the middle of your mandala, or you can make a frame out of the branches. Add your own acorns to the trees. These are iridescent stickers my daughter gave me. I haven't tried them yet, but they are an option to embellish. Then, of course, we have some stars and a couple more letters. There is that pile. These are interesting, and I haven't got to try them yet, but I want to. These are called tube confetti, so they look like very tiny little straws chopped up into a whole bunch of pieces. I was going to try it maybe in the bottom of balloons or like in the background for a party, but I haven't had a cage to fit it just yet. So here's some more sequins from Dollar Tree. This year they came out with some tree snowflake reindeer, which I really like, so I got a couple of those. These ones are snowflake tree reindeer ribbon snowman. And I did use quite a bit of these last year, so I did pick up a few of those just in case they don't come out next year. I might have an extra or two. Okay, more of the rub-on transfers. Like I said, these don't take any glue or heat or water, anything like that. You just cut out what you want to rub on. I'm kind of close to see these whole things, but we'll make it work. These ones, notice, some are gold like this that are filled in, and some are tarnished looking. I know one lady that thought that hers were ruined because they kept coming off this tarnished look. Okay, I just want to show you these 3D butterflies. They have these in all kinds of things. You can get butterflies, candy, everything, flowers, houses, whatever. But they are super cute. I haven't seen any Christmas ones yet, but maybe they'll come out with a candy cane or two or something. There is that. We talked about the stickers. Double-sided sticky tape can also be your best friend. If you're not wanting to glue, or if you have a bunch of little things, or whatever it may be, it tends not to be so rough on the page as well. Stencils. So I have some letters. Circles, gotta have the circles, and then the alphabet. And I might have to plug my phone in. Maybe we're doing okay. Okay, so stencils are a big part of it. Now, stencils can come like that, they can come single, and you place them where you want, trace them with paint or whatever. Dollar Tree has stencils on a wheel that you can get and cut. Puffy paint is great for like writing names on stockings and things like that. Hole punchers. You can use these on washi tape as well as paper if you want to cut out lots of dots of one thing, make snow out of them, what have you. So hole punchers make for a great embellisher. These are from Walmart. These are a little more pricier, but they are beautiful. I love how they glisten. Here's a gold nail polish I really like. I don't know if my black has any more room. I really like how the gold looks. I would get the extreme glitter, not the weird chunky gold nail polish, to get that effect anyway, because that is a fun one. So there's my nail polish sheet. And I think, other than a couple different pens to play with, that is about everything. Don't forget, you can also use your eyeshadows. I do have a large eyeshadow collection. It's not technically embellishing, but... So these are from Dollar Tree, and they are great. And they have lasted me a while, so I do have an extra set that I haven't even had to open yet. And then same with their metallic and their sparkle gel pens. They only come out once a year, so stock up. Once they're gone, they're gone. And then this one is also the chunkier glitter for snow. I have this more fine one I will be trying also. So